Good. Smart Wargames here. Let's check out Decisive Battle. Battles Korsun Pocket. Also one of the Decisive Battles games and one of the two or three Eastern Front ones. Yeah. Currently on sale, and you might were considering, should I get this? Let's make a short content review. One will only show very bit gameplay. Not really that important, because there's also other videos here on my channel where you can witness more gameplay. And before we head into the game, installs fine on Windows 10, no problems, and runs on Windows 10 with the newest patch, which installer, but you don't need the newest patch, that is done here, already included. And Korsun Pocket, if you visit here this page, I should have added it in the description of the developers. Really nice, they keep still around for these games. Database of custom scenarios like Kreta, entire operational campaigns, and a lot of them, of all front lines. So even if you buy an Eastern Front product, in the end you can play a lot of front lines. I check out the page here. There might be more on the internet. Those games were quite popular, but here, and the downloads still work. That is good. Yeah, manual is here. 50 pages, as most of those Decisive Battle campaigns have. A player guide. Okay, that is a tutorial. Yeah, lesson 2, lesson 3, etc. This game doesn't come with an interactive tutorial, but... Yeah, the music is probably the best wargame soundtrack ever. Yeah, what, Jimmy? But wait, where's my... Okay, I can't show it to you, yeah, but this soundtrack is amazing. I think it was composed by Hans Zimmer, Harry Gregson-Williams, and Mozart as far, but don't quote me on that. Very impressive, yeah. Tunes, DJ Ostfront. Okay, I had to go into a scenario in order to be able to remove the soundtrack, because otherwise, of listening to this greatness, I could not. Typical Russian Timmy appearing in the chat. By the clock, you are late for 30 seconds. Davarish. Now head back. Good. Yeah, tutorial, exactly. That's those lesson I talked about. You can't even get out of this menu, is that correct? There's no button. You now need to do the tutorial, Davarish. Resume? No, that starts it. Yeah, okay. There's a main menu button, but you need first to start this. There's, you know, there's sometimes those games that lock you into a screen. Yeah, and this player guide is meant to be alongside it. This game, I think, is the oldest of the Decisive Battle series, but they run basically all on the same engine. It includes also the Battle of the Bulge. I think there was a separate release by SSG, because I also found at least the mentioning of a Decisive Battle the Ardennes Offensive, and perhaps for the re-release or Matrix release, they bundled it up or something. Not sure if that is but perhaps back in the days it worked out. If you market a game as Eastern Front and hide Western Front inside of it, most people won't notice. And that is not some little stuff here. Yeah, if you load that, I mean start that. That is huge swing, yeah, this is here. I mean, it is smaller than the new decisive campaigns. I wonder if this has something to do with decisive campaigns, decisive battles. Is that a homage? Decisive campaigns? Decisive battles. Yeah, but exactly. You have your Bulge if you always wanted to play that in this. I think there's another game also coming with Bulge scenarios. But okay, why not? Yeah, more it's fine. I think most people won't notice. Release a game. But you see there's also a lot of custom scenarios or mods out there which allow you to play a ton of other theaters. Good, now but we will check now out Korsum Pocket, that's the name of the game. And as usually, you usually have an epic campaign covering the entire AO, the entire map. But you have also limited campaigns, yeah, like something like this. Let's see, something smaller. Yeah. Last stand of those pocket forces. I mean, perhaps you can work it out and destroy them, or hold the position until the time runs out, I guess that is. You will be destroyed sooner or later historically, but that's what I mean, yeah, you can design a scenario, then here a time limit might be, or a victory point, whatever, in such a scenario things make sense, yeah, if you play multiplayer, because otherwise you say, oh, we'll get destroyed anyways, where's the fairness, no, and then, I don't know, you hold up long enough to make, whatever, yeah, you get the idea, then the challenge is to survive long enough. Why is the settings looking like a map? That is so, that is we. That is a map, right? Look at it. This is really a symbol I wouldn't expect for preferences. Yeah, this here, but this here is saving, loading. That should be. Yeah, okay. It's not, but not that important. So let's return to the menu and check the others, but there's also some smaller included, and you see, especially with those modded ones. I guess I got the exit button. Really don't know how to exit the game properly. I think there was somewhere a main menu button, but whatever. Not a big thing. So, Korsum Pocket. And usually the grand campaign is called like that. And yeah, we'll play both sides now on human, but you can also select a computer because I want to prevent from the last video that I will end up with AI calculation and then it will take ages until I gain control again. Hello, great to see game stream just before the Matrix sale ends. Yeah, great. Yeah, true, it ends today. And I will try to get this DLC for Kharkov done. And then you can still decide buy or no buy. Good, let's head into Korsum. Yeah, again, I mentioned it already. The map, okay, here looks again a bit crazy with colors. And the unit counters look different. Ah, that's because we are now on the Soviet side. We don't have information on the Germans. But it is still better than in some of those European games where the contrast can be quite crazy. And yeah, compared to Kharkov, this here is a bit more grounded when it comes to counters. I mean, there might be reinforcements and then it becomes a big clash, but the Kharkov one was really hardcore huge. Yeah. Here it is again a bit Yeah, this is a lot of counters, but looks like you can manage it. Exactly, if you select a unit, typical error that will happen to you, happens to me, is you want to select something else and the unit starts to move all over the place. This game has an activation system where you activate a unit. If you don't need it anymore, deactivate it. I don't have another button to deactivate this selection. And so always make sure to deactivate the unit afterwards. Otherwise you might want to select somebody else and trigger movement. Screens. Yeah, Battle Advisor, which gives you an overview of battle chances with current deployment. OOB screens of the different armies belonging to the different fronts. For the Germans it is then also higher command. Yeah, settings, that is, I guess, rules and scoring. No current score. Supply is here depicted a bit. Oh no, that is not supply. That is supply. Yeah. And this seems to be the supply routes. Supply routes, supply flow. Cut the supply route, no supply flow. Yeah, so they have basically two screens. That is the supply route, which you want to keep open, crucial. And which if you cut them down, then basically the rest will be not like a, like a vessel. And here you see the entire distribution of the supply along the front line. Then you have sometimes supply assets, which you can give. Here, let's say we want to attack here. Okay. Not Jimmy. Seems like last move you're allowed to undo, just because that is also a big thing in many games. You're not allowed to do that, and if you misclick, you fail. Basically, either need to reload or to accept it. That can be quite annoying, especially in single player. I mean, this rule makes sense for multiplayer because of Fog of War. In single player, it is rather annoying because, I mean, who does that checking out? Yeah, but sure, it might be people that check out. You can also cheat yourself. Yeah, there's indeed people that cheat. I know from here people cheating results in single player wargaming to show off. Not only show off. Yeah, to show off. I don't know. To impress Mama. Good. Yeah, now let's do some combat. I selected here those two for air support, but there's... which one was it? Those two Tonys. I mean, there's nobody here. What are you supposed to attack here? There's nobody here. Okay, that is definitely not... The offensive is planned here. Here I should undo. See? Oh, damn it. Yeah, you can do only one undo, but better, that is good enough. So we see here's a tank, tanks amassing, so I'm pretty sure that would be a good breakthrough here. And let's see if you can already attack. Can move into the gap. Yeah, let's start with infantry forces, yeah. Try to open a gap and then with the tanks drive in. McDonald's drive in. Let's check quickly Arty. Those guys are in range. You see this dotted line? Those guys are anti-tank. Those guys in range. Yeah, we should have enough Arty in range. Let's perhaps bring some tanks forward. Wait, you belonging to the 53rd 2nd Ukraine in front. That's it. Do you have some support here? Which one? 53rd. Also belong to the 53rd. But there's some bunkers, some the fortifications here. And here are mines placed, it seems. But in order to expand the front line, we might need to do it. So they're independent. Yeah, they belong also to the 53rd. They're independent. Those units that don't come with a special icon, and they have this short names, but they all have the short name. 30, yeah, but that is a T-34, 34 tank. Yeah, what can I also call it? No, that is a unit, 32 tank. I was thinking it is the T-34. Yeah, coincidence. No, I don't want to push into those fortifications. Yeah, okay, yeah, let's, it doesn't matter. You select here battle, we might not push in. And then you select the enemy. Then you're broke to the battle preparator or whatever, your battle screen. Okay, the buttons look a bit similar, different. You can allocate RT. And the game automatically draws units. You see those lit up units? I guess that means forces that can participate with some sort of support, yeah, be it RT, rockets or whatever. And you can also assign other support assets, or you simply press max and then everything is allocated. Yeah, 3-1, it's not the best. For assaulting fortified positions, you might need more. I don't think we can handle this in turn one. You would prepare a way stronger battle. I mean, did we bring up tanks? I don't think so. The tanks are always a good thing. Anti-air. It's not that important. Anti-tank. Yeah, rocket RT. Is rocket RT in range? Ah, look at this. A rocket RT is not in range. That is, a rocket RT is really good for softening positions. Let's drive them a bit forward. Now they could fire. I hope they have enough movement, because you move them. Could be that they can fire. Let's try to attack again. It's 44, yeah, that looks way better. Those tanks, and I guess, yeah, the rocket RT. No, I don't think it is participating, I guess because we moved. I'm still not happy. Tanks. Should we give me tank army 18 tank corps? Those guys can't reach. And the stack is, I guess, this is already overstacked here. Yeah, okay, then let's pull it off. Right, bring in more infantry. No, this everything is full here. Full house. Nah, we didn't manage. What did we manage to break through? No. They held 239th infantry. But they took quite some losses. But they held. With better preparation and softening up those positions, you will break through very fast and probably as on turn one if you do it properly. And yeah. That's what you do here. I am counter pushing. And trying to encircle some Germans while the weather is very hostile. The amount of counters is, I think, sweet spot for many. Okay. Yeah, later I will stream the Kharkov DLC, because that is, I think, never, this was never covered, which should be how many should be before the sale ends. Yeah, exactly. One thing with alt you can activate. Yeah, perhaps that might be interesting for some. I mean, especially if you play at 1200 resolution, that might be not even that bad. Like this Windows function. Perhaps sometimes it might be helpful if there's a lot of stuff going on. I never need it, but others might need it. Yeah, so it's fine. Alt. Good, back in a minute.